Have you ever looked up at the night sky and wondered if we are alone in the universe? The question of extraterrestrial life has intrigued scientists and stargazers alike for centuries. Enter the Drake equation, a scientific formula that attempts to estimate the number of civilizations in our galaxy. This equation is the brainchild of Dr. Frank Drake, who in 1961 sought to frame the question of alien life in a scientific context. The Drake equation does not provide a definitive answer, but rather a statistical means of organizing our ignorance and assumptions. It offers a way to break down this vast question into smaller, more manageable components. Each part of the equation represents a piece of the cosmic puzzle, from the rate of star formation to the lifespan of advanced civilizations. So stick around as we delve into the components of this fascinating equation and explore the probability of life beyond Earth. The Drake equation is a probabilistic argument that breaks down into seven primary factors. This equation, formulated by Dr. Frank Drake in the early 60s, is an attempt to estimate the number of active, communicative extraterrestrial civilizations in the Milky Way. First, we have the rate of star formation, symbolized as R star. This represents the average number of new stars created in our galaxy per year. Understanding this rate is crucial because stars are the basic building blocks for planetary systems. Next, we have F sub P, the fraction of those stars that have planetary systems. Not every star has planets orbiting it, but recent advances in astronomy have shown us that planets are more common than we once thought. Third in line is N sub E, the average number of planets that could potentially support life per star that has planets. This factor considers the so-called Goldilocks planets, which are neither too hot nor too cold for life as we understand it. Our fourth factor, F sub L, is the fraction of those planets where life actually develops. Life as we know it requires very specific conditions, and it's not enough for a planet to simply be in the habitable zone. The fifth factor, F sub I, is the fraction of planets with life that develop intelligent life. Intelligence is a tricky concept to define, but in this context, we're talking about life forms capable of creating technology that could be detected from space. This leads us to F sub C, the fraction of planets with intelligent life that develop a civilization which releases detectable signs of their existence into space. This is the kind of life we're really interested in when we talk about finding extraterrestrials. Finally, we have L, which represents the length of time such civilizations release detectable signals into space. This is arguably the most uncertain factor in the Drake equation, as it involves predicting the future of civilizations. Now that we've broken it down, let's dive into each factor in more depth. Star formation is the first variable in the Drake equation. It's where everything begins in the cosmic drama that ultimately leads to the potential for life. So let's dive into just what it means and why it's so crucial. Imagine our galaxy as a vast cosmic nursery. The stars are like countless babies being born over time. Some are gigantic, others tiny. Some burn bright and die young, while others smolder gently for billions of years. This is the rate of star formation, and it's the first piece of the puzzle in the Drake equation. Stars are the architects of the universe. They forge the elements needed for planets and ultimately life itself. But how often are they born? Well, that's a great question. In the Milky Way, our home galaxy, it's estimated that about 7 new stars are born every year. Yes, every year. That's 7 potential new solar systems, 7 new chances for planets, and perhaps, just perhaps, 7 new opportunities for life as we know it. But it's not as simple as just counting the number of new stars. We also have to consider their lifespan. Massive stars burn through their fuel quickly, living only a few million years. In contrast, smaller stars, like our Sun, can live for billions of years, providing a stable environment for planets and life to potentially develop. So the rate of star formation isn't just about how many stars are born, it's also about the types of stars that form and how long they live. This factor significantly influences the Drake equation because it sets the stage for all the other variables: the number of stars with planets, the number of habitable planets, and the potential for life. In other words, understanding the rate of star formation is like understanding the pace at which the universe is creating opportunities for life. Stars are the birthplaces of planets, so it's important to understand how often they form. Not all stars are created equal. some have planets orbiting them. This simple statement introduces us to the second variable in the Drake equation, the fraction of stars with planets. This variable is crucial because, in the vast cosmos, not every star plays host to a planetary system. We used to think that planets were rare, but thanks to advancements in technology and the tireless work of astronomers, we now know that's not the case. We've entered an era of exoplanet discoveries, where planets beyond our solar system, known as exoplanets, are being found at an astonishing rate. NASA's Kepler mission, for instance, has discovered more than 2,000 exoplanets since it launched in 2009. And that's just one mission. Other projects and observatories worldwide are also contributing to our growing exoplanet catalog. This surge in discoveries has provided us with a revised view of our universe. We now estimate that virtually every star in our galaxy has at least one planet. Some stars even have entire systems of planets revolving around them, much like our own solar system. These findings have significantly impacted our understanding of the second variable in the Drake equation. We've come to realize that the fraction of stars with planets is not a small, negligible number. Instead, it's a value that's likely closer to one, meaning that there's a high probability that a randomly selected star will have planets. However, it's important to remember that our knowledge on this subject is constantly evolving. As our technology improves and our exploration of the cosmos continues, we're likely to discover even more exoplanets. This means that our estimates for the fraction of stars with planets may change. In the grand scheme of things, the universe remains a vast, largely unexplored territory. Every new discovery brings us one step closer to understanding our place in it. Every exoplanet we find could potentially answer the age-old question: are we alone in the universe? With the constant discovery of new exoplanets, this variable is ever-changing. But one thing remains certain: our journey of exploration and discovery is far from over. Out of all the planets in the universe, only a fraction might be suitable for life. This is the focus of the third variable in the Drake equation, which considers the number of planets per star that could potentially support life. But what exactly does it mean for a planet to be suitable for life? Firstly, the planet needs to be in the Goldilocks zone, or habitable zone, around its star. This is an area where conditions could be just right, not too hot, not too cold, for liquid water to exist on the planet's surface. Water is a fundamental requirement for life as we know it, making this zone a key area of focus in the search for extraterrestrial life. Secondly, the planet should have a suitable atmosphere. Just like Earth's atmosphere protects us from harmful solar radiation and helps regulate our planet's temperature, a habitable planet would need an atmosphere capable of providing similar protections and conditions conducive to life. Thirdly, the planet would ideally be geologically active. Geological activity, like volcanic eruptions and tectonic plate movements, plays a crucial role in recycling vital life-supporting elements and maintaining a planet's magnetic field. Lastly, the planet should have existed for a sufficient amount of time. Life, as we understand it, takes billions of years to evolve from simple microbes to complex organisms. Therefore, a planet that's too young may not have had enough time for life to develop. However, it's crucial to remember that these criteria are based on life as we know it. Life elsewhere in the universe might be radically different and thrive under conditions that we consider inhospitable. Scientists continue to explore these possibilities and refine our understanding of what makes a planet habitable. So while the universe is vast and filled with an unimaginable number of planets, the fraction that could potentially support life is significantly smaller. Finding a habitable planet is just the first step. Life as we know it also needs to develop. A daunting task indeed, but one that continues to inspire our search for life beyond Earth. Life as we know it is complex and requires specific conditions to develop. As we delve into the fourth variable of the Drake equation, we grapple with the question: what fraction of habitable planets actually develop life? This is not as clear-cut as it may seem. Life doesn't just pop up because a planet is in the Goldilocks zone, where conditions are just right for liquid water to exist. There are many factors at play. For instance, the presence of certain elements like carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, phosphorus, and sulfur, often referred to as the building blocks of life, is crucial. These elements combine in myriad ways to form the complex molecules that make up living organisms. But having the right ingredients is just the starting line. The planet's atmosphere, its magnetic field, tectonic activity, and even its relationship with its moon or moons can all influence the potential for life to arise and thrive. Let's not forget about time. Life as we understand it took billions of years to evolve on Earth. This means a planet needs not only the right conditions, but also the stability over an incredibly long period of time to allow life to develop. It's also worth noting that we're discussing life as we know it. Life elsewhere in the universe might be based on completely different principles and require completely different conditions. This adds an extra layer of complexity to our estimations. The sheer number of factors and their interplay make it challenging to put a definitive number to this variable of the Drake equation. However, each discovery in the field of astrobiology, every new exoplanet we find, brings us a step closer to refining our understanding. If anything, exploring this variable underscores the remarkable circumstances that led to the development of life on our own planet. It's a humbling reminder of our unique place in the cosmos. The development of life is one thing, but what about intelligent life that can communicate with us? Intelligent life does not necessarily mean technologically advanced life. That brings us to the fifth variable of the Drake equation. This variable represents the fraction of planets with intelligent life that develop advanced technology. It's an intriguing concept to ponder. We humans, for instance, have only been a technologically advanced civilization for a tiny fraction of our existence. It took us hundreds of thousands of years to move from discovering fire to inventing the wheel, and another several thousand years to progress to where we are now. It really makes one wonder, doesn't it? So, what are the factors that influence a civilization's leap into the technological age? There are several to consider. A stable environment is one. Frequent natural disasters, for instance, could hinder progress. Another factor is the drive for innovation. The desire to make life easier, safer, or more efficient can fuel technological advancement. Then there's the matter of resources. A civilization needs access to certain materials to develop technology. For example, without metals, it would be tough to build anything more complex than stone tools. But let's not forget societal structure. A civilization might need a certain level of social complexity before it can support the specialists who invent and improve technology. And finally, we must consider time. Technological advancement is a slow process. It takes time for knowledge to accumulate, for inventions to be improved upon, and for technology to become widespread. So when we consider this fifth variable of the Drake equation, we're not just asking if intelligent life can develop technology. We're asking if it can overcome the challenges and navigate the path to becoming a technologically advanced civilization. But even if a civilization does reach this stage, there's another question we must ask. How long can it sustain this level of advancement? How long before it exhausts its resources or its technology leads to its downfall? Technological civilizations may exist, but for how long? This brings us to our next variable, which we'll explore in the following scene. Longevity is the final piece of the Drake equation puzzle. Our journey through the cosmos now brings us to the sixth variable of the Drake equation, the lifetime of advanced civilizations. This is the average length of time that a civilization can maintain the technology necessary for interstellar communication. In other words, how long can advanced civilizations sustain themselves before they fall silent? This is a question that touches on everything from technology to sociology, politics, and even the environment. Consider for a moment the lifespan of our own civilization. We've had the ability to communicate across interstellar distances for just over 100 years. Will we still have this capability in another 100 years, 1,000, or 1,000,000? The longevity of a civilization is perhaps the most uncertain variable in the Drake equation. It is influenced by a multitude of factors, many of which are difficult to predict. For instance, a civilization might collapse due to internal strife, exhausting its resources, or succumbing to a natural or self-inflicted catastrophe. On the other hand, a civilization might find ways to overcome these challenges, continuously reinvent itself, and extend its lifespan. This could be through technological advancements, efficient resource management, peaceful cooperation, or even colonizing other planets. The lifetime of civilizations is also important because it affects how many civilizations might coexist at the same time. If civilizations only last a few thousand years, the chances of two or more overlapping and being able to communicate with each other are slim. But if civilizations can last millions of years, then the galaxy could be buzzing with conversations. However, we must bear in mind that all these are speculations. We simply don't know how long a civilization can last, and our own experience is far too limited to offer any reliable guide. The Drake equation gives us a way to estimate the number of civilizations, but remember, it's just an estimate. The Drake equation is a fascinating tool for pondering the possibility of extraterrestrial life. It's a vehicle for our curiosity, a mathematical formula that allows us to estimate the number of civilizations in our galaxy that we might one day communicate with. In this journey, we have explored the components of the Drake equation, delved into the significance of each variable, and understood how they shape our perspective on the cosmos. We've seen how star formation rates, the fraction of stars with planets, and the number of planets suitable for life are critical components of this equation. We've looked at the factors that could lead to the development of life and how that life might evolve into intelligent beings capable of advanced technology. And we've considered the lifespan of such civilizations, pondering the many factors that could influence their longevity. But it's important to remember that the Drake equation is speculative. It's filled with uncertainties and assumptions. Each variable is a best guess, and small changes can dramatically alter the result. Yet, it's these very uncertainties that make the Drake equation so captivating. It embodies our quest for knowledge and our yearning to understand our place in the universe. The Drake equation, despite its controversies and criticisms, has sparked a global interest in astrobiology and the search for extraterrestrial life. It has permeated popular culture, inspired countless works of fiction, and fueled our collective imagination. As we continue to refine the variables, improve our technologies, and make new discoveries, we edge closer to answering the age-old question: are we alone in the universe? So let's keep wondering, keep questioning, and keep exploring. The universe is vast, filled with mysteries waiting to be solved. Let's embrace the uncertainty and the thrill of the unknown. After all, it's the questions we can't answer that fuel our desire to learn. The search for extraterrestrial life continues, and the Drake equation helps us to quantify the unknown.